In this video, I'm going to walk you through the anatomy and function of your penis and pelvic muscles. We're going to go through the misconceptions around doing Kegels, and then I'm going to share with you some tips and tricks on how to enhance your sexual experience using Kegels. So to begin, let's talk about the anatomy. So we need to understand our body and how it works before we apply any type of strategy. Here's your pelvis. Here are your butt bones. That's the anus, and that's the base of the penis. And you can see that there's a certain set of superficial muscles here that are wrapping or supporting around the base of the penis. Now, these muscles are considered your superficial pelvic floor muscles, and they help with maintaining and sustaining an erection and also with ejaculation. They squeeze and release during ejaculation. So, inside of the penis, however, your erectile tissues, you have three structures, three erectile tissues that inflate to fill with blood and also drain. You can see here, it's kind of like a hot dog in a bun. So in the middle, you have your corpora spongiosum, and then on the side, indicated by a little black Play-Doh here, are the corpora cavernosa. And then the yellow that you see running through here is the dorsal nerve to the penis. So you have neurovascular structures, nerves and blood vessels that run along the shaft of your penis all the way to your head, the glands. Now these structures fill with blood, and they also have connective tissue that wraps around them to maintain their rigidity and integrity. Now, just like any other part of your body, we all have our own unique variability in how much is too much, too fast, too soon, too hard, too soft, etc. So it's important to get to know your body and how those parts work on your own body so that you can gauge how much is healthy for you, especially when it comes to sexual function and enhancing your experience during sexual activity, introducing Kegels. So, erectile tissues, inflatable balloons, think of them as inflatable balloons. They fill with blood, they drain, and they also have neurovascular structures that run all along and in between these structures. And then you have the muscles of the pelvic floor wrapping around them as well, and parts of them actually going all the way up to two-thirds up the shaft of the penis, and that's your bulbospongiosus muscle. So when you have an erection, the pelvic floor muscles tense up. So the intensity on their muscular contraction and tone increases to help keep blood flow in your penis. When you're ready to ejaculate, these pelvic muscles have to squeeze and release several times to help pump semen out of your body. One thing to note about Kegels and how this all pertains to what I'm talking about is there's a common misconception about doing Kegels and over Kegeling, right? So constantly tightening, contraction, contracting, hard, fast, more, build up, right? What people don't realize is that it's just as important to soften and let go. And I know you don't want to hear the word soft when we're talking about your penis, but bear with me here, fellas, okay? Through that softness and that gentleness, trust me, there's going to be a strength that arises. Why? How does that make sense in terms of your pelvic floor? Well, for one, if you have a lot of tension and intentionally squeezing around your penis, that actually can create a bit of a problem to help get blood flow into your penis. Because if you have a constriction around structures that need space to fill with blood, then that actually may hinder your ability to bring blood flow into your penis and to maintain blood flow into your penis. Because if we're constantly tensioning and squeezing and, you know, really trying to beef up this endurance and stamina when we haven't really built up to that, your muscles are gonna poop out really quickly. Like, endurance. So you get muscular fatigue, and then there's gonna be maybe some crabbiness here. So just know that range of motion and being able to, just like with you see with my fist here, I can close my fist, I can open my fist. In order for me to have proficient and efficient movement and tissue tolerance and adaptability and variability, I have to be able to do both squeezing and opening. Squeezing and opening. So that's the same thing when we're talking about your pelvic muscles. It's about coordination, fellas, not so much about building up power and endurance. Don't get me wrong, that is important, but we do that with fluidity and gentleness and a relaxed intensity, which will actually help increase your stamina and your endurance and your power for when you want it and need it the most. So I hope that makes sense. Another thing I wanted to mention about adding Kegels during sexual activity is that we have to remember that your penis and the structures that make up your penis have sensitive neural structures and tissues that have a certain limit to them. So if we increase the pressure, so you squeeze your pelvic floor muscles, which happens naturally, but if you add intentional squeezing to add more to that pressure, then that actually is going to increase the penis pressure. If your body is such that it's used to doing that because you've worked up to that point, then that's a gradual buildup in that tissue tolerance, and you're able to tolerate that type of demand. But if you're someone that is just trying these out for the first time and really trying to get to know your body, then adding too much too soon, too quickly, may actually pose for potentially a risk for injury or discomfort or pain, etc. So just know that these structures are very tough. Don't get me wrong, they can withstand a lot. I mean, just type in bull riding. Those bull riders' pelvises tolerate a lot of pounding. Again, no pun intended here. But you get my drift, right? So any type of activity that we're introducing to our bodies, we really need to be mindful of, you know, have I done this before? Have I practiced this enough? Do I know my body enough to know when I'm kind of reaching a certain threshold that may not lead to the best results, okay? That being said, if you are currently experiencing sexual pain, pain with ejaculation, pain with erections, or pain anywhere around in the pelvis, then adding Kegels to your sexual menu or your sexual repertoire may not be such a great idea initially. Again, if tissues are sensitive to begin with in a painful way and an unpleasant way, and we add more demand of them, so we add to the tissue demand, the tissue workload, then that actually may potentially increase the dial on the sensitivity of the pain being experienced. So if you're experiencing sexual pain in any form, I would probably advise that A, you seek counsel from a qualified pelvic health practitioner or sexual medicine practitioner who can help you navigate kind of building up to this point. But B, perhaps maybe you focus on the gentleness, the letting go, the softness within the pelvis first, and then play with the gradual building up of tissue demand, tissue tolerance, and variability. And last point I want to make here, as far as a strategy, we really don't know how much is too much for any one penis. That is really still up for debate. So it really is an individual exploration of getting to know your own body and knowing how much is too much for you as far as intensity, frequency, number of repetitions. Think about the context, like everything else that happens within your sexual experience as far as adding in Kegels. And remember that it's just as important to contract as it is to let go. Think about it as a very fluid, relaxed intensity where you're adding into this experience, and you're really exploring what that feels like. To finish this video, I would love you all who are watching to think about adding in Kegels, which happen, you know, pelvic contractions happen naturally when you have an erection and you ejaculate. But what's your intention with adding in Kegels during sexual activity, whether that be masturbation or otherwise? What are you hoping to gain out of adding intentional pelvic floor contractions to your sexual menu? I think it's always helpful to ask the why behind the what we're doing this for, so that you can gauge and assess whether or not something is truly working for you or not. So I'll leave you with that. Thank you all for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe and hit the like button below. This will help other guys in your situation also find these resources sooner than later. If you're a penis owner who's currently struggling with pelvic pain, you're not alone. Check out the Men's DIY Pelvic Pain Relief Program. The link is in the description below.